Hello everyone, this is the Tarot Queen Jamila. I'm here to do the May love reading for the Aries. Okay, so this is going to be kind of like a not so full month. It's May the 3rd. I am so sorry I am late, but you'll still get a lot out of this reading. And then we'll also do a mini forecast. Okay, so I do apologize for being late, but we'll look at what's going on. I think you guys are going to really like this tarot spread. Okay, Aries, it's a 6-card spread. I haven't used this one. This one is going to explore what's going on now, like what you should do now. What kind of sexual chemistry. So this is for couples and singles. I'll try to see what I can see for you single people. But this is about, like, card number one will be what action you should take, the sexual chemistry between the person that you're involved with, the emotional connection, external influences. Is there a long-term potential in this person that you are with or just recently met? And then also the outcome. Now, again, this is a general reading. I do offer this very same reading. This is perfect for my 30-minute reading. And if you want to get a personalized reading, especially if this reading resonates with you or if it doesn't, it should. Okay, I'm just going to be honest with you. but yeah, definitely check me out for a personal reading. I do also offer 1-hour readings as well as 2-hour. Okay. And then I also have a store. So definitely go check that out. You want to go to shop. It'll take you to shop all, but go to shop. Okay, so we're going to be looking for the love life for those involved and then the singles for the month of May 2016. What action to take, what sexual chemistry is there, the emotional connection. How are people externally influencing it, any long-term potential, and the outcome. Okay, so hopefully for you Aries, I got my fingers crossed for you. I'm really excited to finally be getting you your reading, and I'm so sorry for the voiceover, but I just don't want to get on camera. Okay, it's just kind of how I feel about YouTube, so I'm sorry about that. But this is sort of the format of my personal readings anyway, unless you get a Skype reading, and then you'll be able to see the illustrations and you'll get a lot more out of your personal reading. So that'll be kind of like the extra thing that you'll get. So that'll be like, hopefully that'll inspire and encourage people to come and get a Skype reading. So, all right, I'm done shuffling. So I'm gonna lay the cards out. I hope you guys are enjoying spring so far because it is so beautiful over here in the South. All right, so let's explore card number one. Now, this is what you should do now. This card will let your subconscious tell you what you should be aware of in your particular situation, either about yourself or about the other person. For example, your fears may be limiting your options, or the other person's expectations are an obstacle in reality. Okay, so maybe that person just has some very unfair expectations of you, you know. So you did get the Page of Swords. I'm sorry, the Ace of Swords. I would say, Aries, you need to take action. This is what you need to do right now. You need to take action. You need to contact this person. The Ace of Swords is sort of like a new beginning, a very fast beginning. You may have already been thinking about taking the plunge, but you do definitely have the ability, the inner strength to, you know, go out there and find somebody. So if you're single you need to get out and do some traveling, and you need to go out and take some action. Either go on some dating sites if you can't go nowhere. If you've got like special needs, you know, check out the website. If you don't like meeting people just randomly in clubs or at bars, or you know, if you've been invited to a wedding, you need to make sure that you go, and you need to make sure that you look nice. Now, if you're already involved with someone, you need to go ahead and take action. Okay, probably you've already been thinking about that, because there's definitely an angel right now that's pushing you. I see this angel as being Cupid. No matter what religious background you are, there's always a Cupid, unless, I don't know, it's Christianity. I don't know who would be Cupid in Christianity, but you know, there are several Cupids, you know, Lord Vishnu and the goddess Lakshmi, their son was actually Cupid, a Hindu Cupid. So I definitely do see some angelic spirits right now that are urging you. And you need to listen to those spirits, because I think right now you're not trusting your intuition, because those spirits are your intuition. So for you to have the Ace of Swords in your subconscious, this is telling you what you should be aware of, which is you're not going to make something happen until you take action. Okay? It's just not going to happen unless you do something. Okay? Also, this is pretty cool, guys, because your subconscious is really what, your subconscious can have a deep, deep effect on what you manifest. So, I do see a lot of you as being very strong-minded and just being on the pursuit to achieve something, and it's going to require for you to do that. So, if you're currently involved with someone, I get the sense that the sexual chemistry is very emotional. It's soul crushing because you got the Three of Swords. It drains you a little, but that's okay, because, you know, both of you are feeling the same way. So, and I think that's so beautiful to get this in this position. It just says to me a very tender engagement with another person, because, and then I also get the sense that there's some extra stuff going on, because for it to be the Three, I'm not going to buy three too much into that. Now, if you are not currently involved with someone, I get the sense that what you are looking for is something that is going to sort of crush your soul. Okay, I have known Aries people to be sort of masochistic, and that's sort of what you're looking for. And because you are such a powerful personality and you radiate so much heat, that you get so many men or women throwing themselves at you, and you would rather deal with someone that isn't chasing you. Now, the emotional connection, if you are single, that you're looking for, is you are really looking for balance. I also get the sense that you're both going to be healing each other's broken hearts. So if someone has a lot of baggage, or what is perceived to be baggage, maybe you need to just be patient, because, you know, patience is really important. Now, the emotional connection that you want, Aries, if you're single, is that you want someone to perceive you as who you are. You want to be understood, because you got the Two of Wands. So this is all about identity and personal identity, the whole wand suit. So you want someone to see you as an equal. It doesn't mean that you if you're a woman, you're trying to dominate the man. That's not what that means. What that means is that you want that person to understand you like they understand themselves. And you want that balance to where you want to be loved unconditionally. So this is a very, very positive card to get the Two of Wands in this position. So I do see a lot of really positive things happening for you in your love life, especially with the Three of Swords showing up under the sexual chemistry, because this is all about healing your broken heart from this third person that's kind of involved with it. And I think it's one of you that's heartbroken, but it might be both of you. Card number four, these are the external influences. I'm sorry, let's go back to three real quick, guys. I meant to tell you, if you are currently involved with someone, this card just means that you really, really, really want to work at this relationship. So this is not only, this is about teamwork as well. Okay, so, you know, if you're in a marriage, you know, you just want to remember it takes teamwork. Even if you're the man and you're out working, you need to remember that running an entire household and taking care of children is very exhausting. You know, and, you know, you just want to make sure that, you know, the communication is there. Now, externally, you did get the Knight of Pentacles, so I do see this as a literal person in your lives. I see this as an older person, probably in their 40s to early 50s. They might even be younger than that. Maybe they're in their 20s or 30s. I mean, the age could vary. But this person is really interfering with the relationship. Card number four. The external influences, there may be circumstances greatly influencing this relationship's success. It might be career, it might be other people, for example, family. So I do see this as being maybe someone might be involved in some sort of family business, is what I'm kind of picking up from the Knight of Pentacles. I think you want to make sure that you don't get distracted. This person might be, you know, kind of pulling you away. If you're single, you want to just let your boss know to quit riding your back, okay? It's important to make money, because I get the sense that, you know, this Knight of Pentacles, you know, this is someone possibly involved in the stock market, some sort of investments, or maybe even entrepreneur. But I get the sense this is a co-investment, and so maybe this is a co-partner in a business, and they're kind of like, hey, you need to get back to work. So I think that's important. But if you need a vacation, take it, because I'm seeing this as someone at work. If you are involved with someone, same thing. This also could be family. A lot of family are going into business these days, guys, because of, you know, the need for people to be self-reliant and independent and not dependent on our government. So a lot of people are trying to get themselves off of government programs and things like that. Okay, once you have done that, you have truly left the matrix. Card number five, does this person have any long-term potential? And you got the Lovers. So that is just amazing. I'm going to give two interpretations of this for both the single and people involved. So if you are single and recently met someone and you're wondering about that person, yes, they are a keeper. Okay? They're going to stick around. If you are married or currently involved with someone that you want to marry, I think this is a definite sign. This is a major arcana and a major life event. And I get the sense that for some of you younger people, and even the older ones, for you to get the lovers really indicates that you're going to be doing a lot of sexual exploration. This is a twin flame connection. So if you meet somebody, Aries, you're going to meet your twin flame. For those involved, I would say this is a definite sign. I get the sense that some of you are writing letters and emails and, you know, sending love messages. Also, the Knight of Pentacles can point to someone in your life sending love messages for you. Another interpretation of the Lover's card is that there are a lot of you Aries out there, either you or your partner, that are at a crossroads. It's really interesting because when you look at the illustration of this picture, the man is being bitten on the leg by a snake. I'm not real sure how to interpret that. There's a lot of sexual energy coming down from the moon. And a lot of times when you have a twin flame, the energy between the two of you can make you almost feel as though you're at a crossroads, because often twin flames are, you know, lovers that are meant to be, or, you know, I guess by God or whatever you consider to be God. They definitely are leaving some sort of situation behind that is probably not what they should choose. You know, in fact, the Lover's card, when you look at it from the pagan standpoint, in the pagan tarot, the Lovers is has a really beautiful definition. I can't wait till I can use those cards again. I've got to order another deck, guys. The Lover's card in the pagan meaning, the illustration, I can see it. There's a dark road with people already turning their back because they're jealous of you and whoever you're with. And then there is a road that has sunshine and happiness. And so, I mean, it's impossible. I mean, this is a major life event. You're going to take the happy road, okay? So for it to be in this position, you know, this person is a keeper. Now, your outcome. And we're going to consider this for the month of May. Is the Six of Wands. So Aries, if you're wondering when your lover is going to claim you in public, this person is going to do it very soon. If you're wondering if he's going to pop the big question, he is going to do it very, very soon. If you are single and you're not heavily involved with someone, I would say that you guys, this Six of Wands is what you got. It's the outcome card. I'm sorry, guys. I get kind of ahead of myself. I'd say if you're single with the Six of Wands, it was right on the tip of my tongue. And I need to turn off my phone because my phone can really disturb me during readings. It was something I wanted to say. You're going to be going out on lots of dates. If you're Aries that have been waiting for someone to wine you and dine you, you are about to get that is what I wanted to say about that. So I think that your theme for the month of May is going to be lots of public displays of affection is what I'm going to say. I hope you guys enjoy the new layout with the cascading, cards that you got. In your reading, so that you can actually look at the illustrations and you'll know what they look at. Thumbs up for that new format, since I don't like getting on camera and sometimes I like to just do voiceover. Make sure that you subscribe. I am at 3,000 subscribers, and so stay tuned and make sure that you subscribe for my 3,000 subscriber giveaway. So you're going to be getting something from my online shop free of charge. So I'll see you guys later. Thanks for watching. Bye.